What's up? Sean here, and today is a big day. The Bevel Pro, Bevel's latest add to the lineup. Many of you guys probably have the Bevel Trimmer. Version 1 and version 2 came out a few years ago, and so this is their very first 2-in-1 clipper and trimmer set all in one package. So we'll start off with a quick unboxing, kind of go through all of what comes with the Bevel Pro, and then we'll start to break down some of the key features that are new on the Bevel Pro, as well as my first thoughts and impressions. Now, keep in mind, I'm not a barber, so I'll be reviewing the product strictly from the perspective of consumer, somebody who, you know, typically line themselves up, shape up their beard, their hairline, things like that, in between trips to the barbershop. So this is gonna be kind of a review from that perspective. One of the first things you're probably gonna notice when you unbox the Bevel Pro is the packaging. Now, Bevel's always been really good about their packaging. It's always been top notch. And so this is no different. And I think this is really cool how they've kind of laid this out. Shows all the key features on the back of the box. Also on the other side, something that Bevel started to do on a lot of their packaging, you know, some of the products that come in boxes, you know, is showcasing imagery of black men. And I think that's super cool. Kudos to Bevel for doing something like that. Just being able to showcase us on the sides of the box, it's huge. And so I, you know, want to give credit to that. Love to see more of these. So Bevel, continue to do this on all of your packaging. I think that's a great nod to the people who use the products the most. The first thing you're gonna see inside the box is gonna be the Bevel Pro unit. Inside the box, you're also going to see the square blade that is included with the Bevel Pro. And then there's also gonna be a set of 5 different guards. So guards numbers 0 through 4. We'll break down kind of some of the measurements of each of those in a second. And then there's just the usual things like the blade brush, the little carry travel case that also acts as a polishing cloth, and then the charging cord. First thing you're gonna wanna do before you even use the Bevel Pro at all, it comes travel lock. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is actually turn travel lock off. When you open up the box and you try to power on the Bevel Pro, you're gonna get a little indicator on the Bevel dial. It's gonna show just 2 solid white lines as well as those kind of blue rings that go around. Typically you would see numbers there. If you're not seeing numbers, that means it's travel locked. All you have to do is just hold the power button up for 5 seconds. And then you'll notice on the Bevel Dial LED that you'll see numbers there, as well as kind of where your battery power is indicated. So because the Bevel Pro is motion sensitive, they've installed that feature just to make sure that, you know, you're not draining battery power if you're on the go, if you're traveling somewhere. So once you've disabled travel lock, you can then power on the Bevel Pro. And the first question most people are probably gonna ask is it any louder or quieter than the Bevel Trimmer? Side by side, you know, this is kind of the different sounds. We're gonna have the Bevel Trimmer first. And then the Bevel Pro. And then both of them together. So the Bevel Pro is not any louder or any quieter than the Bevel Trimmer. There's a little bit of a pitch change just in general because it has a 6,000 RPM motor in it. But in general, you're not gonna really notice a drastic difference or change between, you know, noise level as far as when you're using either the Bevel Clipper or the Bevel Trimmer. Vibration in it is actually really good. So when the blades are in operation, you're not getting a whole lot of feedback or shake in the handle. And I think that's super important. You know, as barbers, as well as folks at home, if you're gonna be shaping yourself up, you know, you really wanna make sure that, you know, the unit isn't vibrating so much. And I think they've done a really good job of just making sure that the quality of the materials, no surprise from Bevel, you know, just really highlighting some of the build quality in this. It feels super solid, it's heavier, it's a little bit bigger than the Bevel Trimmer. So those who are familiar with how that feels in the hand, you know, this feels very, it's hefty, but not overly heavy. It's not something that you would get tired of using from the weight of it. It's very nicely balanced. Even when we talk about some of the blades, you know, the blades have been done amazingly well. Big fan of them coming in all black. The blades themselves have a black graphite coating on them. So that's gonna help repel any of the dirt, debris, oil, things like that when you're kind of cutting your facial hair or cutting your own hair. So I think it's super huge. I mean, just the build quality. If you purchase anything from Bevel, you know that the attention to detail, the quality and the innovation that's done in these products is just, it's top notch. And you know, again, I love to see that in the grooming space. For a lot of men, you know, we're starting to get into that space where we're taking better care of ourselves, and Bevel is right at the forefront in creating these products that really feel like they're paying attention to us, that they're listening, and that they're putting the effort in to really create products that, you know, are really built very solid and high quality. So when we talk about the blades, so there are three different blades for the Bevel Pro. The first is going to be the actual clipper blade. So that's gonna be the larger blade that you're gonna see that comes standard on the Bevel Pro. That's gonna be the first blade that's already gonna be attached. That'll be your main blade if you're gonna be cutting actual hair. It's more durable, it's able to handle larger amounts of hair at one time, and it's the only thing when we get to the guards that the guards fit on this this blade only. And then we also have the T-blade and the square blade. So the square blade comes standard with the Bevel Pro unit, so that'll come with it as soon as you order it. It's included in the package with the Bevel Pro, and then sold separately is gonna be the Bevel T-blade. So that's gonna be your other trimmer option. Again, some people have a preference between square blade and T-blade. T-blade just gives you a little bit more range and a little bit more flexibility when you're trying to cut and trim. But again, sold separately. For those who ordered on pre-order, you may have already received your T-blade with that package. It was actually included for no additional charge. And then Bevel is also offering a bundle package that is also offered on their website that includes the T-blade with it. You just have to pay a little bit extra, but it's still a discount, roughly about $15 cheaper than buying them both separately. So related to the blades is gonna be the power fade gap control. So, you know, most clippers, you're probably used to seeing, you know, a lever that's on the side that would allow you to adjust blade gap at any given time. What's nice about the Bevel Pro is that that's done digitally. So there's no lever on either side, and you no longer have to remove the blade like on the Bevel trimmer and use the dial to adjust the blade gap all the way to zero. It comes with power fade gap control, and that's gonna allow you to use these two buttons here to adjust the blade gap and all the way up from 0.0 to 2.5 millimeters. So it adjusts in 0.1 millimeter increments. So you can easily just press the button once at a time and it'll adjust it precisely to those millimeter increments. Or you can press and hold, it will take it all the way to 0.0 or as high as 2.5. So you have a little bit of range in between there. Now there are some clippers out there that have a lot more play and range in that. For barbers, that's probably gonna matter a little bit more than for the consumer. But in general, being able to adjust this to adjust the blade gap at any given time using these two buttons is super nice. It keeps the profile of the Bevel Pro unit very sleek and just allows for a lot of precision without so much guesswork. When you're trying to switch out the blades, for those who have purchased the Bevel trimmer and are familiar with that, the same snap and lock modularity that's on the Bevel trimmer is also on the Bevel Pro. So super easy to remove blades. All you're gonna do is take both of your thumbs, put them towards the outsides of where the blade is, leave a finger on the back to kind of hold, you know, the blade so that it doesn't fall. And then you're just gonna push outward and just the blade just snaps right off. And then all you're gonna do is take the other blade, whether you're gonna use a square blade or the T-blade, you're gonna line that little bracket up at the bottom with the bottom of the Bevel Pro. And then you're just gonna press in and snap into place. And what's super cool is that unlike most trimmers, you're gonna be able to use the power fade gap control on both the square blade and the T-blade. So being able to adjust the blade gap the same way you would on the Bevel clippers and the clipper blade, you can do the same on the T-blade as well as the square blade. So it just gives you the level of range and functionality that you normally wouldn't have in most trimmers that you would typically have to add a guard to and those types of things. It's really nice to have that flexibility for a trimmer blade, whether that's the T-blade or the square blade. Do the square blade, the trimmer blade, and the clipper blade fit right on the Bevel trimmer? And actually, no. So the Bevel trimmer and the Bevel Pro are actually two different sizes. So in most imagery, you're probably not gonna notice the difference. But when you put them side by side, they both feel very different. The Bevel Pro is a little bit heavier. It's a little bit wider and bigger. So you're just gonna notice, you know, that, you know, when you try to switch the blades in and out, they're not gonna fit together. The Bevel Pro blades are specifically designed for the Bevel Pro and won't be retrofitted. They won't be able to work on the Bevel trimmer. So unfortunately, you will have to get, you want the actual clipper blade, you're gonna have to upgrade to the Bevel Pro and be able to get those units. But again, the Bevel Pro is specifically designed for somebody who's gonna be cutting hair on a consistent basis, whether that's your own, whether you're a barber, all of those different things. The Bevel Pro is that two-in-one package. So again, the trimmer is a little bit more focused on just trimming and lining. You can cut hair here and there, but it's not gonna be quite as durable if you're using the Bevel clipper blade, which is specifically designed to cut that level of hair. And then when we take a closer look at the Bevel Dial LED display. So One of the coolest features on the Bevel Pro is being able to see exactly what your measurement is at any given time. So there's no guesswork. You're gonna be able to kind of see exactly what you're dialed into. There are a couple ways to read this. So you're gonna be able to see the number in the center. That's gonna show you exactly what your blade gap is in 0.1 millimeter increments. That blue dotted dial that's going around, the bevel dial, is a battery indicator. So it's gonna show you exactly what your battery progress is, you know, forever, how long you're using it. To break down the battery life, Bevel Pro is rated up to 4 hours of continuous runtime. And that's the same whether it's cordless or corded. So, you know, that power level doesn't decrease. You don't get less power out of the Bevel Pro if you're wireless, if you're not plugged in. And then if you're plugged in, same thing. You're gonna be able to get the full amount of power out of the Bevel Pro. So either way, whether you wanna use it with or without the plug-in cord, the power stays the same. And I think that's super important because there are a lot of clippers out there that lose a little bit of juice, a little bit of power when they're not plugged in. The only downside with the battery power is that it does take roughly about 3 hours to charge from empty. So just keep that in mind. I think one of the things I would have liked to see Bevel do is offer a quick charge option. Being able to, you know, if you're on the go, if you're on the run, and you need a little bit of juice, the same way you would do your phone. You know, a lot of phones nowadays, smartphones will have, you know, a quick charge option where you plug it in for 15 minutes, get you maybe about, you know, 25, 50% there. That would be great to have that as an offering for the Bevel Pro, to be able to quick charge it if you need it. And then if you need to kind of plug it in for that longer duration where you do have the time to fully charge it, you have that option. You can leave it plugged in and it's not gonna damage the battery life. And then lastly is the pivot locking guards. So this is actually my favorite feature on the Bevel Pro. And I think this is super, super cool the way they've done it. So quickly, let's break down the guards. So we have guards numbers 0 through 4. So the 0 guard is gonna be 1/16 of an inch or 1.5 millimeter in length. The 1 guard is gonna be 1/8 of an inch or 3 millimeters in length. The 2 guard is gonna be 1/4 of an inch or 6 millimeters in length. The 3 guard is gonna be 3/8 of an inch or 10 millimeters in length. And then the 4 guard is gonna be 1/2 inch or 13 millimeters in length. So there's a lot of room here. Bevel also has an additional set of guards that you can now order in a large guard set that will give you more flexibility when you're cutting longer hair. But for the 5 guards that are included with the Bevel Pro unit when you order it, those are the ranges. And I think it's super cool. So again, my favorite feature on the Bevel Pro is gonna be the pivot locking guard. So super simple. There's a magnet that's on the back and it magnetizes to the actual blade unit. So what you're gonna do is really just line the teeth of the actual clipper blade up with the bottom of the teeth on the actual guard. You're gonna line it up at the top there. It fits right in, and then you're just gonna allow it to snap into place. It magnetizes itself, and it's actually very, very secure. So as you're kind of cutting hair, you're moving with it, it's really locked into place really well. And I think that's one of the coolest things, to be able to easily snap on, snap off guards without having some little clip at the bottom. Sometimes the guards can come off here and there when you're cutting hair, when you're shaping your facial hair up. This is very, very secure. So there's no, like, I don't feel a lack of confidence when I'm using this. It feels very solid, very secure. It's not gonna come off super easy. And then if you wanna remove it, the easiest way to do that is gonna be able to grab the top here with just your hand. You're gonna be able to grab both sides of the clipper. You're gonna push down and then you're gonna pull out. So being able to kind of switch in between, in and out of these guards, I think it's just super, super cool. I mean, again, Bevel did a really amazing job. The actual guards themselves do not feel cheap. They're very durable, hard plastic. They don't feel overly thin and brittle to the point that they could easily break or snap, especially if you're cutting very coarse hair and it snags. The actual ends of the guard are actually a little bit rounded. So that's gonna be nice, a little bit more comfortable when you're cutting somebody's hair or your own. You're not gonna be kind of scraping at the scalp or your face as much. It's got a nice, slight rounded edge. It's gonna be a little bit more comfortable on most people's skin and scalp. So the price for the Bevel Pro is gonna be $329.95 on getbevel.com. For a lot of people, the biggest question is gonna be, is it worth the price? So when you hear $329, you're probably gonna feel like, you know, that's a little bit more expensive than probably what most people are thinking. And I think one of the key things to call out is that, you know, obviously when you look at clippers in the space, you know, they're hovering around $175, $200, right? You know, for a really solid pair of clippers. But the other thing you have to remember is that you're also getting a clipper and a trimmer in one. So you're not having to get 2 separate units. To be able to have the capability of not just to be able to trim your hair, which is what most trimmers on the market can do. They can trim your facial hair, maybe line up a little bit, but they can't really take on larger amounts of hair. To be able to have that capability in one unit, Not to mention the build quality that comes with when you get something from Bevel, the quality, how it holds up, how durable it is, and then all of the guards that come with it, the blade options that you get from both trimmer and clipper, and then just some of the innovation and technology when we talk about the bevel dial, power fit gap control, and then snap lock modularity. So the biggest question is it worth the price? I think for a lot of folks who at home are gonna be cutting their own hair, if they cut their family, their children's hair, if you have a beard that you would prefer to shave at home, this is gonna be worth the price. I do really think that Bevel has done an amazing job with it. I think it's worth the price. I think it's solid. I think it's super innovative. And it's a tool that's gonna cut down on all the other stuff that you probably have in your bathroom. You know, when you're talking about all these different trimmers and clipper options and guards and things, it really cuts out a lot of that and keeps things super, super simple. And me personally, I'm actually super minimalist, so you know, I really enjoy the ability to have all of that capability and flexibility in one unit. So it cuts down a lot of clutter in the bathroom and things of that nature. So I do really feel like it's worth the price. However, if you're somebody who's really just only gonna be lining up a little bit, hardly at all, if you're somebody who doesn't really shape up their own facial hair at home and doesn't plan to, it's gonna be pretty hard to justify $329, so I totally understand. But I think, you know, for those who are gonna get full utility out of the Bevel Pro, if you're gonna use it how it's intended, barbers for sure, those at home, again, are gonna be either shaping and lining themselves up, I truly think that the Bevel Pro is worth the price. So a couple things I'd love to see from Bevel next for the Bevel Pro is a charging dock. I think instead of, you know, the traditional, you plug it in with a cord, I think it'd be super cool to actually have some sort of a charging docking station. I mean, the way this is designed looks so amazing on a countertop, at a barbershop, on the shelf. So to be able to have some sort of a docking station that keeps this upright, kind of sit it in, it charges, and then when you're ready to use it, you just remove it and go at it. I think that would be super cool for Bevel to design and come up with. I'd also like to see a guard organizer. So I think one of the cool things if you're gonna store the guards is that they do magnetize together, so you're able to kind of keep them neat and organized this way. But I'd love to see some sort of a case or some sort of a container where you can put these guards in there. It's super easy to see all the guards that you have, especially if you're starting to get some of the larger ones that they offer, and just be able to keep all of your tools in kind of one place in a container or a box. It typically comes with that little polishing cloth that's a pouch, but to try to fit all of your guards in there, all of your blades, all of those different things, pretty cumbersome. So it'd be really nice to be able to have some sort of a case that actually goes with it, and even a carrying case for the Bevel Pro for those who don't want to just keep it in a little pouch. I think something for $329 should come with a really nice solid case that just fits nicely, looks really good, easy to carry around, and also keeps all of your other tools super organized. But I'd love to know what you think, so let me know in the comment section below if you plan on picking up one of the Bevel Pro units. And also let me know what you're interested in seeing from Bevel next, you know, whether that's, you know, the carrying case or the charging dock that I was talking about, or if you have another idea for something else, let me know in the comment section below. And until the next one, thank you guys for watching. Peace.